I made a video this week on why your bill doesn't work in ESO, and today I want to help you solve some of those issues. I want to help you optimize and help you build your character for success in ESO. I think that everyone wants to enjoy the character that they play, but sometimes they just don't know how to get to that point. But by the end of this video, you're going to know how to build your character and how to get maximum enjoyment out of playing your class or character in ESO. Real quick, thank you to my patrons and YouTube members. I will have more on that at the end of the video. You can also watch me play live, twitch.tv/BravyGotThis. Our Discord and our website, BravyGotThis.com, is all down in the description. Let's go. Now, the first thing I want to talk about is finding a class and a race that you will enjoy before building your character, okay? And so, what do I mean by this? Leveling in MMOs and building characters and playing a build, one of the biggest things that really helps you enjoy and helps you understand how to build your character is a class and a race, or a class and a spec, or whatever game you're playing that you enjoy. You have to find it satisfying. You have to find it enjoyable, because it can totally change your perspective on the game you're playing in an instant. It's something that you really have to prioritize, all right? One of the biggest examples I can say is playing World of Warcraft. I played World of Warcraft and I played a Ranger and I absolutely hated it. And then I pick up World of Warcraft and I started playing a warrior, and I absolutely loved the warrior. It's so much more fun. In ESO, when I leveled up, I didn't really particularly like the Nightblade. I just didn't like leveling up with it. But when I played a Dragonite, or when I played a Stamsorc, I loved it. There are really, really massive differences in certain classes and races that will just make you want to play it more and more. But there's some classes that you just will not like. So I have plenty of resources here in the description and in my channel you can check out. But before you do that, make sure to finish watching this video so you can get some more of these tips. But you want to make sure that you find a class and race first that you really like, and it's no issue if you have to start over and try something else, okay? Because if you just keep playing something you don't like and it's not satisfying, then you're just gonna end up quitting the game. So find something that you like and then you can really get going. That's the first thing. The next thing I want to talk about is optimization of your bar, your skill placements, and your attributes. Optimizations for your bar is just finding the best setup. So I talked about this in my video this week about making sure you place skills that are optimal for your rotation and that are just easy for you to use as a user, okay? So if you're someone who's really able to do a lot of actions per minute, you're able to, like, you know, the keyboard and mouse is something that you just don't have an issue with, then you can really customize this to your full extent. But if you're someone who comes from a tab targeting background like World of Warcraft or something like that, you may have to simplify this as much as possible. So some ways to simplify your bar in ESO is to make sure you line up skills on each bar that are about the same type of thing. So my two skill is a damage over time area of effect, and this two skill is also a damage over time that I do not spam. I also have some other just one-time skills that I use in my rotation. So for instance, my volatile armor is something I pop and I don't just continually keep clicking it. My engulfing flames is the same thing. I use it one time and I do it every 14 seconds and that's it. So I put those on the same key. Now my spammable is on the 4 key because the 4 key is easier to hit than the 3 key. My 3 key is skills that are usually skills I don't have to hit a lot or are buffs, because 3 is difficult to hit when the W key's right below it. That is just how I set up a bar. That is something that will really help you. Now, let's talk about AoE, single target heals and shields, like the kind of skills that you put on your bar. So when you're building your character, you have to realize that if you're building a solo character, for instance, you may need a buff to buff yourself, or resistances like volatile armor, and you definitely need enough damage to output damage. You also might need a heal, right? But if you're playing in a group, you may not need igneous weapons, right? You may not need volatile armor. It's just something that you have to realize that when you're building your character, you have to kind of cater your skills to whatever you're trying to play. You can't just have all damage skills as a DPS. You need to have something that damages over time, that maybe compounds one of your skills. So that's something to keep in mind with that as well. And then when we talk about attributes, okay? So you'll see here you have Magicka, Health, Stamina. The way ESO works is Magicka is good for like spells. Stamina is good for like melee, martial weapon. Health is for you know, a lot of times tanks. But the biggest thing I want you to understand is you don't necessarily always need 64 points into health as a tank, because having more health doesn't always necessarily make you survive more. You still need recovery. You still need resources, right? So you might have to split that up to like 48, 50 health and like 10 magicka and like 4 stamina. For magicka DPS though, you do want all your points into magicka for the most part, because that is going to be the most beneficial. Same with stamina. If you're a stamina DPS, you might want to put all points into stamina. This is something that you need to understand, because a lot of times I see people try to mix and match because they think like, oh, I have no points into health, I'm a solo player. You don't necessarily need points into health as a solo player, because you can get to a decent maximum health without that. And so definitely make sure to look at your builds and make sure that you are really leaning into these attributes. Speaking of optimization though, let's talk about how I optimize my life with the Ridge wallet. Like I said, speaking of optimization, the Ridge wallet is something that I love to use, y'all. It's compact. It has everything I need. It holds up to 12 cards. It has a cash strap that holds my cash as well if I have any cash. And I just love using it. I can carry it anywhere. And it also blocks digital pickpocketers with the RFID blocking technology. And it's got amazing style. This just really helps optimize my life a lot. And I can just use it anywhere. It's just such a great wallet. And like you guys see, Ridge sponsors a lot of videos here because I really do trust their products. So if you want to get a discount 10% off on your order, I have a discount code BRAWRIDGE down below in the description in the comment section. But thank you again, Ridge, for sponsoring this video. Now, let's talk about what stats to prioritize as you're building your character. I would not mix and match stats and try to do everything. You want to have a focus, okay? For instance, if you look at my item sets here, you know, False Gods right here, you'll see the 2 and the 4 piece item set adds crit chance, okay? You'll see that these Ice Heart pauldrons and Helmet, the one item, is crit chance. You'll see with Briar Heart that the 2 and 4 piece items are crit chance. The 5 piece item set for Briar Heart is based off of critical damage, okay? And also off critical strikes. You see that my build has a theme. The theme is critical damage and crit chance. What you do not see in my build is you do not see item sets like spell damage or weapon damage. So for instance, a set that would do that is War Maiden. And you'll see War Maiden adds a little bit of crit chance, weapon spell damage, and weapon spell damage to magic damage abilities. You also see a set like Burning Spell Weave. Burning Spell Weave also adds max magicka, crit chance, weapon spell damage. It increases weapon and spell damage when you apply Burning Status Effect, which is still good for a Dragon Knight, right? But my build is focused more on critical damage and critical striking. I'm not saying that you can't have item sets that have max magicka, weapon, spell damage mixed with crit chance. I'm not saying that you can't mix that necessarily, but if you're trying to go for a high spell and weapon damage and a high crit chance, you're not going to have enough resources to essentially get to that point. Your returns, I feel like, are going to be pretty diminishing. So if you want to go for a spell damage build, go hard into spell damage, okay? If you want to go for a spell critical build, go hard into spell critical. That's something that I think some players make that mistake. They try to do everything, right? They try to get everything. And the thing is, you can't necessarily have everything. Now, if you're doing hybrid, they've made things a lot easier to hybrid in this game. So you can actually get the same amount of weapon spell damage and weapon spell critical. But I'm just saying that really having a focus, like have a focus point when you're building your character, like, oh, I want really high crit. So let me find things that are gonna get me really high crit. You know, don't try to just go all different ways, because if you do, a lot of times it's just not going to work. Next thing I want to talk about is finding armor sets that work for you or that are going to work for your advantage or help you depending on what you're building. One of the biggest examples I can get is, let's say you're building a solo build. This character is a solo build character. This is my MagDK solo build on YouTube and on my website. It runs False Gods, Briar Heart, and Ice Heart. These item sets are fantastic for solo play. False Gods, the reason that is because you get a speed boost, you have reduced magicka abilities, you get magicka back, it keeps your sustain up. Another reason why this is great is because Briar Heart. Briar Heart heals you a ton. It lets you survive. Ice Heart is also great for solo because it's also going to do damage, but it's going to give you a damage shield. You have to think outside the box here when you're building your character. If you're building a solo character, you need to make sure that your sets are giving you damage. You need to make sure your sets are giving you some healing, probably, and probably some sort of shield You're not gonna be able to necessarily do all of it, but you need to make sure that in some way, it's not just a glass cannon, because solo builds are different than group build. There's gonna be a different setup for solo players and group players, because when you're with a group, you can get a lot of stuff from your group members without sacrificing an item set that you have to wear. But if you're solo play, you've got to bring that to the table yourself. You've got to bring, you know, sustain, you've got to bring healing, you've got to bring shields. So you've got to find armor sets that really complement that. And the last thing I'll say about that is the armor sets have to be something that you like using. If you have all Mother Sorrow and Medusa, you may not be liking it. It just may not feel good. It may not feel like it's doing anything. It is probably doing something because these are two good sets, but you might just have to switch it up a little bit. The next big thing I want to talk about is enchants and traits when you're building your character. These are important. These are very, very important. Do not miss this. Your chest piece, your legs, and your helmet give you the biggest enchant bonus. That's why you see a lot of times those pieces of armor are infused, because they have a higher weight, essentially, of like a bonus. So on a tank build, you may see them put a tri-stat glyph on their chest and have it infused because it's gonna give them more resources than if you put your tri-stat glyph on belt, because the belt's not gonna give as many resources. So placement of that is important. Enchants and traits really matter, y'all, because it can be the difference of you having more max stamina, more recovery, and that is really important. You'll see here on my Briarheart, I don't have the trait that I want on these two rings because I haven't finished this build on the live server. If I put max magic traits on here, that's gonna be another almost 1700 magic. That's gonna really help me out. And so for me, I wanna make sure that I get those on these jewelry pieces here. One of the biggest things I wanna say that is, if you're a tank, that can matter a lot. With tanks, you have a smaller margin of error, because with tanks, you not only have to have enough health, you've got to have enough magicka and stamina, or you're not going to be able to use your abilities. You're not going to be able to block. You're not going to be able to survive in a fight, and then your team's going to wipe. So as a tank, you have a lot more responsibility with understanding that your enchants and traits really do matter a lot. And so when you're watching a build video, make sure to really pay attention to that. Make sure to have the stuff that they're talking about, because it does matter. It means something. Other thing I want to talk about is not stacking major or minor buffs, okay? Something that some people don't understand about this game is, in this game, you have major and minor buffs. What are these? You look at Volatile Armor here. It says you get major resolve, increasing your physical and spell resistance by 5948 for 20 seconds. Well, there's also a minor resolve, which gives less resistance, but you can have minor and major resolve at the same time. But what you cannot have is you cannot use this skill and then have another skill that gives you major resolve. You cannot stack Volatile Armor's major resolve with another skill with major resolve. It doesn't work. And so if you're in a group and your healer and tank is giving you major or minor resolve, you don't need Volatile Armor. It's not really doing anything other than the damage. So you've got to really pay attention to that. This is big for healers and tanks, especially for item sets. You don't want to start using item sets that give you Minor Slayer. Like if you use False Gods and like some other set that gives you Minor Slayer, that is doing nothing, because you can't have two accounts of Minor Slayer. You have to have one major account, one minor account. That's the only way you can stack that. The reason that I don't have Innerlight gives Major Savagery and Prophecy, which is weapon and spell critical. What does this give? Major Prophecy and Savagery, increasing weapon and spell critical. There's no reason for me to put Innerlight on this bar, because it's not doing anything with Flames of Oblivion, because you can't have double stacking of that. Does that make sense? So make sure that in your builds, you're not stacking those buffs, because they're not doing anything. You want to make sure you have minor and major buffs of the same thing if you can, but you cannot have the same major buff. It does not stack. Next thing is optimizing CP, okay? We always talk about this, but you got to optimize CP. If your build is not using, let's say, any single target abilities, you don't need deadly aim. It's doing nothing for you. If your build has all area of effect abilities, you want to have biting aura for the most part. So you gotta make sure you read these CP stars and make sure they are actually utilizing what you have. I have a video in the description on damage in ESO, and it explains all of this as well. Okay, and one of the biggest things I wanna talk about, and this is like I said in my video this week, is when you're building your character for success, you want to put the time into your build. You have to practice your rotation, okay? It's important to practice your rotation on your build on target dummies, right? But I think it's even more important to practice your rotation in the world. Do it in activities. That will allow you to get a more accurate representation of how you can handle things.
Rick, not hit back.
Because here's the thing, it's good to practice on the dummy. You can sit here all day and do your rotation. You can sit here, you can just hit your buttons, you can get amazing at light attack weaving. You can just learn how to weave your light attacks and your skills together. You can block, cancel, you can do everything by doing that. But if you get to content and you die instantly and you don't know what you're doing and you can't do that mechanics, it doesn't mean anything. It means absolutely nothing.
Stay still.
Oh no. So I advise to get a basic understanding of your rotation by going to the dummy and practicing it some, getting used to bar swapping, getting used to canceling a little bit, and then going to content. Just play content. Get in the heat of things. You've got to learn how to play through mechanics, okay? Because you're not going to be able to just stand there.
Oh, just don't hit back.
You've got to move around. You've got to switch bars. You got to know when to do certain things. That is one of my biggest tips I can give you when it comes to building your character for success. Now, if you want any other tips, I've got tons of videos up here in the cards that can help you out with your character in ESO and just in general. And thank you again to my patrons. Again, you get perks like early access to videos and much more. Thank you to my YouTube members. And you can watch me play live if you want to check this out. Twitch.tv/probablygotthis. Our website, probablygotthis.com, and our Discord, all that's in the description. But I do appreciate all of you being here. Just remember, have faith, be great, and I'll see you on ESO.